guys. Here we go. EL Gaming versus Kongdu. Set number one on steps. Kongdu is going to start off on the defense. And here's our tanks, like we said. EL Gaming using the SU-8 on the offense here.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's on this map, defense or offense, there's a lot of different things you can do. But with the play styles of these two teams especially, it doesn't matter as much where you go or whether you're on the attack or not. It's usually going to be a game that's decided by elimination and not base capture. We have seen some exceptions to the rule. There are a few strategies where you trick your opponent and just send three tanks in, and if you don't get hit, you cap it. Like, that's something that Run would do, or TCSG. But the high-level teams are not really doing that. They're going for elimination. So there's going to be Doo-Doo, by the way, on the MT-25.
Okay,
and Reflection, as you would expect to see, on the artillery.
This is great. EL Gaming really rushing base capture number two, but it looks like they want to just take that fight straight on. Doo-Doo is on the MT-25, and he's seen them all. He's like, oh god, guys, we're going to have to retreat a little bit. And we can see here, Kongdu doesn't want this fight.
Well, you know, the artillery, a long, long reload time. I misspoke earlier saying it was in between. It's actually a bit longer than the M44 in reload. It's over 20 seconds. Now, keep in mind, it's strange that EL Gaming went for the side push. Keep in mind that they have this artillery, so when they go for a big attack like that at the second capture point, they're down a tank, essentially. I think they're just trying to posture and scare Kongdu off. But now that they've retreated back, they've lost quite a bit of time, to be honest, Susie.
They have, but you know what? Okay, so now you can see Kongdu on the mini-map. You can see that they are in the same, in the position that we usually see for defense. They're going to camp out in their spawning point near base capture 1 and 2, where they have a good view on them both. And the Chinese teams, they just like to shoot, let them know their position, you know, whether it's to distract them or really to give them position away. We don't know that.
Right, so it's kind of, again, a lot of these mind games that come into the 7v7 battle. Still no damage done to either team. The Su-8's just been, I mean, I don't want to say useless, but it just hasn't connected yet.
It hasn't.
Gugu Jungman in a really good spot on the right side.
Oh, very, very close, though.
Cow Thief over here, the shot caller. There's a shot of him right there, narrowly escaping that damage.
Gurgur Jangman. Gurgur actually means, it's a sound that pigs make.
Yeah.
And Jangman is like an awesome guy, so he's like oink oink awesome guy. Yeah. That's his name. I don't know. Korean names, man.
It makes sense in Korean, it doesn't make sense in English.
We that's don't need it. We're in Korea, it's okay. We don't need it to make sense
exactly,
in the English.
Exactly. So, all right, well, this slow push towards the second base capture, they have gained a lot of ground. But what happens next is the most important part, of course, once they start to engage.
They are going back to where they rushed to in the beginning of this game. It is 4 minutes and 12 seconds, and Gurgur Jangman, he's like up in the high ground just waiting to see that shot.
You know, I'm not a big fan of the SU-8. I understand why they use it, but the Kongdu is just countering it with a different sort of formation here.
Okay. Oh!
A missed shot here, and his position is revealed, and Spring and Guanren are firing on him, and so is Adam.
Yep, it looks like Gurgur Jangman is going to go down, and he may be the first tank out of the game.
Guanren takes the shot. Fox doesn't have to waste his. Now, Spring is actually starting to hard engage here. Again, they're missing a tank because they did choose an artillery.
Yes, and
we do see Deung takes the kill on Spring. Guanren gets very, very low. He's surrounded here.
This is exactly what EL wanted, was to take the fight and just make it a huge crossfire here. I'm not sure if Kongdu is going to be able to take care of this effectively the way that they need to.
Adam taking a lot of damage here.
Nice from the back, just trying to clean up shop. He does. He goes ahead and takes down Red Bull. Doo-Doo does take out Adam, but he is very, very low. Yep, here he goes. Nice. Finishes him off.
Fox, if they can take Fox out here, I think they can actually win this game, but they have to take Fox out soon before Xiu Papa gets taken out.
Xiu Papa is going to try to get him, but Fox is just going to, he could just ram him right now if he wanted to.
If Fox wins this fight, Elong wins this battle. This is actually the most important part. Cal Thief actually now engaging on Nice. Cal Thief was looking the wrong way, so if Nice gets a kill here, it would be a huge turnaround. Fox, one more shot. Can he make it? He's got to reload.
Oh, Xiu Papa. Cal Thief takes him out, but Nice is there to clean it up.
Okay, now it's a lightweight versus a T-32. Kongdu on the defense, but he needs to escape here.
He does.
Ugh, I don't think he can get away.
Wow.
If he gets away here, it's going to be very difficult for Elong to actually take this win.
200 HP left on Xiu Papa right now, and he's just going to try to run away. There's 2 minutes, though, which means the remaining members of EL Gaming can take a base if they want to. There is still enough time.
Yeah. But...
but the SU-8, he's like so far away.
So far away.
And
there's still enough time for
that speed to get to that base capture.
There's still enough time for Nice to actually capture solo. But once we hit 139, a solo base capture is no longer a win condition in this game. So I always want to point that out. If he gets denied one time here.
Okay, well, it looks like Reflection is going to go ahead and join Nice in that base capture. See if they can just defend it and kill off Shihu Papa. Again, Shihu Papa down to 200 HP. One more shot and he is done.
Now, Shihu Papa has a much higher attack speed. He has a much higher rate of fire. So he actually has a few more opportunities to take shots. Whereas if Nice misses one, Shihu Papa is going to hit him for sure because the time it takes to reload is big. Now, Reflection is actually coming here to threaten. I like that because on an artillery, tracing down a T-54, you're probably never going to hit it. So it's better to just sit on the base capture.
Okay.
Now, Shihu Papa needs to hit some consistent shots here. It's going to be very difficult.
He is, and we are down to 15 seconds now, and it doesn't look like he's anywhere close. He wants to catch him off guard, though. I like the fact that he's kind of coming around all the way from back. See if he can go through these trees. But he does need some kind of cover, man, with 200 HP. That's one shot.
8 seconds to go, and he has to make the shot. And if he gets killed before, it won't even matter.
Oh, but Nice is...
he took a great pass, but he's not aiming the right way. Can he connect it? He does!
Oh, he does! And the base capture.
But he's going to have to do more than that. He's going to have to do it again. And now they see him.
Yeah, they know where it came from.
But remember, Reflection's probably not going to make the shot. It's all about Nice. It's basically a 1v1 with two tanks in the capture. Okay, he's going to have to hit that. He wants to wait till the last second.
He needs to hit that for sure.
Oh, my goodness.
But you can see here,
Nice misses. And Reflection, Reflection misses. Nice can still fire. Shihu Papa needs to fire.
And
Reflection goes down, but it's still captured.
Wow. And EL Gaming is going to go ahead and take that first game.
Whoa.
Okay. Whoa. We'll just leave it at that.
That was game one. That was game one. You gotta win six more.
This is what happens when you put two of the best teams in all of Asia to fight on steps of all maps.
This is looking very good for EL Gaming. They essentially went for a 6v7 brawl type fight. The brawl type fight, I like to call it that because it essentially is a brawl.
Yep.
You have seven tanks versus seven tanks, mostly lightweights, but a few tankier ones to sort of give that extra damage and also that longevity, I guess almost a more sustained fighting. And they did this with an artillery, which means they were down a tank to take the fight. That shows insane confidence, accuracy, confidence, confidence that they're going to be hitting the better shots, they're going to have the better focus fire.
Now, we know that EL likes to do these kind of brawl fighting, right? This is what they brought to the grand finals at the end, and that's how they got to the second place spot against the Russian team. Now, Kongju, I was talking to Dudu yesterday, and he was telling me, you know, their strategy is more like be silent, find your position, and then attack all at once. And right now, that's not working for them, as they were the one who's got ambushed by EL Gaming, who was really good at brawling.
So, same tanks for Kongju. I would not be surprised. I would have not been surprised if Kongju teched in like an IS-3 for like that better fight potential. The question is EL Gaming going to bring the SU-8 again? It was not very effective in that last game, but that's part of why EL Gaming is very scary, because even though it basically did virtually no damage, they still won the fight.
Yeah, but imagine if that was an actual tank.
Yeah, imagine if that was a 12-ton. It would have been one-sided. So. The reason why they bring the SU-8 is because the meta in Korea and often or in other parts of Asia like Vietnam, you know, the Hong Kong teams, is to bring in IS-3 or two T-32s and have them hold the position so that you can't even approach either capture point. That's when the SU-8 comes in handy, because while the opponent's team is kind of turtling and hanging back, you can actually hit them from afar and disrupt them, force them into somewhat of disarray so you can actually approach them while they're no longer in their perfect spot with their T-32s and or IS-3.
Okay, this is interesting that EL Gaming has not revealed the last four tanks just yet.
There's a lot of discussion. Reflection is you know, asking his teammates, you know, probably, do we want to bring that SU-8? Because they're not showing us that IS-3 and the T-32 is, you know, they're not actually forming up the way you would expect to see.
Okay, the T-54s, as we expected, there's four of them now, five of them now. And what is this last tank going to be? I really hope it's not the SU-8.
I think they're going to bring it.
Oh, they are. Okay, all right.
This does force Kongju into a, you know, that sort of brawl situation. If you had two even teams, if you had two teams that are exactly the same skill level, like literally 50-50, Eel would never be able to win the Brawl sort of fight, you know, with a tank down. But because they're so good, they're essentially with this SU-8 trying to force a scenario where that fight happens. And they're just simply saying, even a tank down, we're so much better at this that we can actually beat you.
All right. Well, we're going to have to see if they're going to be able to pull it off again. Will that SU-8 help? I don't know. We're going to have to see as we get into game number two. All right, set number two has begun. EL Gaming versus Kongju, and EL taking that first map. Kongju on the defense one more time.
Okay, let's see how Kongju sets up the defense this time. Look at this, the second the timer stops, the second it's go time, they all turn their turrets and rotate and go for the same sort of push.
They sure do. I mean, the SU-8, we had mentioned, it's an arty. We don't see it as often. But this has the furthest range of most of the artillery tanks that we know. And it has a really high arc. And I think that's very helpful.
It's basically, it gives, like, if we could actually see a range meter, it would cover three-fourths of the map.
Right.
Right, for the SU-8. So it's got an insane potential to do damage. However, because this map is so big, there's so much... You know, you can move a lot. There's got so much more mobility. You're not hiding behind buildings versus an artillery on this map, but it's just simply put, the map is so flat and open that it's hard to hit a target because there's so many different places where somebody could be. Whereas on a city map or a map like Mines, you know the terrain forces the tanks to be in a certain position. You know, you know they're hiding behind a house and they can't move as easily.
Yeah.
It's a lot easier to hit.
All right. Oh, well, okay. So as for this opening here with EL Gaming, they are hugging the east side of the map one more time. But they're not rushing forward like they did for the first game. I think that's kind of what Kongju was expecting because they're all together as well. But yeah, Kongju just kind of sitting and waiting, see what's going to go on. That player, Biv, his name is Bube, which means black bear
yes.
in Korean. I don't know why he named himself Biv in English. But I'm going to be calling him black bear because it's a little...
Yeah.
Cuter.
And of course, E-L-D-Y-D is the word you would type to type Diong in Korean.
Yeah, his name is Diong.
So that's why we call him that. Just kind of keep these things in mind. as we
How do you even pronounce that? L-L-did?
I'm like, you pronounce it Diong.
Okay.
They should have just written it in Hangul, but it would be confusing for viewers. But if you write English like this, it's also confusing, so.
L-did. Diong. All right, very slow start. Already we're down to 5 minutes, and nobody's really making any moves here.
Yeah, Spring took one pot shot, but it's all fine.
Reflection just quietly waiting, see what shots he can take. But yeah, everyone's just kind of, again, Kongju style, where they just wait it out. They don't like to make any noise. They don't want to let EL Gaming where they are. EL, obviously playing the very Chinese style, going to just shoot left and right everywhere, make sure that Kongju knows where they are.
And this is one of the reasons why waiting is good. Fox walks into a trap. Cal Thief even gets a shot on him, so he takes a lot of damage here. And already a Kongju with a massive hit point lead.
They do, but...
And they're in good position, but now EL knows where they are, and this means that Reflection can start to take those important artillery shots.
Right.
But with a long, you know, reload time like this, if he misses like this, he missed here, it's 20 more seconds he's got to wait, and Cal Thief avoids the damage yet again.
He sure does. Nice does take a little bit of damage. He's getting chipped off. Little by little, he's gonna sit in that base. Cal Thief, though.
Oh.
Wow.
Okay, so Nice is trying to aggressively bait Cal Thief into a vulnerable spot here. So Spring and Reflection can take him out. Reflection's gonna take another shot here. Let's see if it connects. No, just barely not.
Cal Thief is doing a great job avoiding these shots. He's just kind of wiggling about, going to try to chip down Nice. And while that's happening, though, Red Bull does go down over on Kongdu's side.
All right, Black Bear and Cal Thief and Gugu Jungman are going to ambush Nice now. He's going to eliminate him earlier. And Shiu Papa and Diong also kind of holding the high ground here is making it tougher for EL to rotate.
All right, EL really does need to just go in there and take this fight, like you said, in a brawl fashion. That's what they're used to. That's what they're good at. And Guan Ren, but this high ground advantage for Kongju is...
It's causing problems, right?
It's not doing EL any favors whatsoever.
Absolutely, but EL takes out Gugu
Jungman.
And Cal Thief, they're behind him at T32. You never want to have people behind you. And now EL in a pretty good spot. They turn that fight around. They're just so good at picking a target and moving as a team.
That close encounter fight is so good for EL Gaming, and they are showing us time and time again why they bring the fight to the team. They're on the attack, you know, like they don't need to do this.
And now it's up to Dudu, the last man standing. But keep in mind, if he can delay base capture, this is still a game he can win, because he has a fast tank. And if he can escape long enough to time it out, it's possible. So he's the best kind of tank to have left. Well, I guess
yes,
a T-54
would
be
not
better.
But not at 2 minutes and 30 seconds.
Sure.
There's 3 tanks left for EL Gaming, and they can just go ahead. I think that's what they're going to do. Go ahead and start that timer. That timer's going to go down so fast. 30 seconds already.
Dudu is going to have to consistently hit the right tanks over there, which he doesn't know which ones they are. He's going to have to keep in mind which ones he hit to successfully reset this timer up to its maximum time.
Right, and Spring is being really smart by just kind of wiggling about. He misses that first shot. That second shot, there is now 16 seconds. The MT25 has an incredibly fast reload, but you know what? He's not hitting anyone.
Yeah, it's just so hard to hit at this vision range. You're so far away, you can barely see anything.
All right, I mean, it's going to be difficult. He's not going to be able to make it in 5 seconds.
He can't see them. He's just taking blind shots.
Yep, and that's it. 2-1-0. EL Gaming is going to go ahead and take game number 2.
All right, 2 attack wins on steps. Now we're going to switch sides. Now, Kongdu playing insanely defensively. But the fights are better every time for EL Gaming, and that's what they're forcing.
Yes.
And I expect that we will see the SU8 again, even on now the defense.
Okay. Well,
because they want to force those fights in the same way. It doesn't work the same way on defense as it does on attack, because on defense or on attack, when you're launching those shots out, you're trying to disarray the defenders so you can get on those capture points. You have that advantage.
Oh, the atmosphere in that booth doesn't seem happy.
No.
I mean, we were able to see the Chinese side. They're all smiles and cheers.
Kaldeep was nervous. And you could see it in that last fight. He got caught behind with 3 T-54s behind a T-32. Obviously, there was a lot of chaos going on in that battle. And it was a good move by EL. But still, it's unlike Kaldeep to get picked off like that. Another problem, you know. Nerves,
definitely. And they have a lot to fight for. This is, they're defending, right? They're defending champions. They want this. They're on the home turf. If they lose here, that's a blow to their pride, you know? And it's not only second place, but how do you lose in your home ground?
Well,
home field advantage.
You no longer say you're the best team in Asia. And after talking so much smack, you got to back it up, right? 4 well, lock-ins on T-54s. Okay,
oh,
we're seeing RU-251s.
Oh, 2 of them. This is new. 2 RU-251s. 251s are the fastest tank that you can see here.
Play, yeah.
In competitive play right now. And the MT-25. So they have 3 really fast tanks. The MT-25 being super fast in reload time as well. I feel like they're going to rush.
This is going to be on the attack, so I think you're right. I think they're going to rush to the top capture point, though.
I think so, too.
Or, you know, the left one, if you will.
Yeah. I mean, the RU-251s, again, it's a German Tier 8 light tank.
Yeah, it's not a Tier 7.
Yeah.
So I know a lot of times you see a bunch of T-54s and 2 tanks that are unusual get locked in. You assume they're 7s, but no, they are 8s.
Yeah.
As you can see by the bar at the top left, which shows, you know, how many of the tiers have been chosen. So
really good damage, really fast speed, especially for a light tank at a Tier 8 level. Faster than the T-54s, in fact. So we're going to have to see how this pans out. I really think this is a super aggressive move by picking these kinds of tanks. They have nothing. I mean, they got rid of their T-32s. They got rid of all the heavy stuff. They're just like, we're going to go zip around, try to kill you, beat you at your own game, because EL, they know that that's what they like to do.
I think EL's going to bring an IS-3 on the map.
Oh, there's the
T-32. T-32, though, they could still add an IS-3. Because an IS-3 would be good against this type of composition. They've no doubt studied how Kongdu likes to play on this map.
Mm.
Ooh, a 1390.
That's
really
interesting.
Rare. If they bring a 12-ton too, oh, the extra damage here is intense.
All right, so now we have 2 autoloaders, and they are lightweight. So these 2 can, they're also very, very fast. The only heavy defense kind of tank they have here is the T-32. Everything else, again, this is going to be a really fast round, guys. This is how I see it.
Yeah, this one could end very soon by elimination. When you see these, the 1390 and the 12-ton on this map, the term for this you want to think of if you're a gamer is glass cannon. High damage output dies very easily, so you need to protect them. They need to be on the edge. They need to come into the fight later in the chaos.
This is going to chaos is the word. This is going to be chaos. This next game, I am super excited to see because you know I like these type of games where they all just go head on and attack one another. But we'll see how it pans out in this next game. All right, guys, game number three has begun. EL Gaming up 2. They are on the defense now. Can Kongju come back and even this out?
That is the question right now, Susie. It's not going to be an easy fight to accomplish. That EL is bringing is pretty serious. I mean, its damage is intense. It's going to be a composition that does well in those sort of fights.
This is totally how I'm imagining like West Side Story right now. They're like all coming out snapping and they're just going to meet right in the middle and start shooting at one another.
Could happen like that. I think they're going to meet at one of these capture points.
That's what I'm hoping for. But this is very surprising. Kongju is actually spreading out. They sent the MT-25 going down south as one of the RUs are heading up north to the first base capture number one.
Now, Kongju is looking for a fight with this composition, no doubt. And they also have the mobility to rotate. So what I mean by rotate is oftentimes you see a group of tanks like this storm capture point number one. It's usually the one that gets attacked first, especially in the Asia League. And then once you get there, you find out how solid EL's defense is. You poke with some T-54s and often a T-32. And then you rotate around to base capture point number two. But Kongju's not bringing a T-32.
No. So right now, the way I see it, I think the whole team's just going to go towards one right now, and they just want to bring the fight over there. If they hit the right tanks, then they can reset the base timer, but I don't know, that's what it looks like. It's just going to be one big team fight, 7v7.
I don't know about this. It seems pretty suicidal. Okay, they're doing it safely. They're not going to pull a TCSG on us.
All
right,
Gurgurjangman taking some shots, kind of letting them know where they are. The location is trying to be revealed. Gurgurjangman is over by the railroad tracks, though, so he's trying to distract them a little bit.
Yeah, he also wants to, if he can get lucky, take some damage off on these guys. Reflection is
right on the edge.
Right on the edge, in fact, facing the wrong way, which is kind of strange. Perhaps to minimize the surface area, I guess, because his turret sticks out that way. So if he looks the other way, he's less likely to be hit by stray fire. Yeah, that's pretty smart, because he's not trying to hit anybody right now. That makes sense. I feel like the way Kongju is going about this is smart because they're going to rotate the second capture point with these RU-251s. They're so fast, they can get there very quickly. But they need to make sure they do it well.
This is really interesting. EL Gaming, yes, they're in the defensive position over by their spawning point. They are still grouped together. And it looks like everyone's in pairs at this moment. The T-32, obviously a little more forward, that want to find a good part of the terrain that they can utilize as a utilize that gun depression, right?
Yeah.
And it's a heavier tank, so it could take more damage.
Okay, they're rotating. They're going all together, but I worry about this because this becomes very obvious. If you leave one T-54 that keeps putting fire, then at that moment, EL doesn't know how many people are left. But if you send everybody, okay, so they're leaving a T-54. I was going to say, if you bring everybody, then it becomes insanely obvious what you're doing, and then EL has plenty of time to respond. 4 minutes left. They've still got, I'd say, about 45 seconds or so before it becomes a dangerous situation where they're kind of locked into where they are.
I'm surprised. I mean, Kongju definitely, with this lineup, they want to fight. They want to fight, but they want to pick the right fight, and they want to get in the good position for it.
They haven't gotten what they wanted.
No, they haven't.
And, you know, makes the picks look almost questionable at this point, but they are rotating to two. There's a T-32 waiting for them. It's nice. The best T-32 player on the team.
Gurgurjangman catching some air there. He's doing some style points on this map. Yeah, they are going to rotate over to base capture number two. EL Gaming has not seen anyone, though, and so I have a feeling they know what's going on.
They haven't, but because they're so far away with their formation, they don't know for sure yet. And they don't want to send Reflection because he's not really a scouter. He's a damage dealer in this game in particular, so he can't really go over there and scout. But that's what the T-32 is doing. Lice is pointed this way, and as soon as he sees more than three tanks, the rest of the team is going to collapse and try to defend this, and we're going to have that big brawl, that big fight that you've been waiting for, Susie.
Yes, yes.
I know this is what you like.
I want this fight to happen.
All right, Nice sees him, and they're going to form up. He sees now, he's like yelling out to his teammates, it's 3, 4, 5, it's all of them.
Guys, it's all of them. We're going to have to come back and take this fight now. Here we go.
See, it took too long, and now Kongdu is going to just have to hope for a good fight.
Yep,
it might be suicidal, but they have to hope for this to be good for them.
2 minutes and 30 seconds left. I mean, they need to bring this now.
All right, the MT-25 actually leading the charge here. And with no heavy tanks in this lineup, there's no tankers here. Everybody's just going to swarm and try to outmaneuver these heavier tanks, especially if they can get that lightweight 1390 off. That would be great. It looks like they're going to go for Nice first. Nice is totally surrounded now.
He is surrounded. He is going to be the focus fire target.
A lot of shots
here.
Wasted on Nice now,
wow,
though.
Wow, he did take. Wow, he was able to avoid so much. And now look, here's the brawl I've been waiting for.
And this is a much better position for EL Gaming. Kongdu has to retreat now. Now, EL Gaming on the low ground in this exact moment was able to win a fight from there. I can't see Kongdu doing it, though. Black charging in.
All right,
Bucks from behind.
Gulgul Jangman does go down. He's the first casualty of the game.
Spring left uncontested to do massive damage on that 1390.
All right, it has been a one-for-one so far.
Down goes Black Bear, Dudu, Cow Thief.
One by one, Kongdu is just dropping like flies, and it looks like EL Gaming is going to win this. Shihu Papa taking damage, and Deong taking critical damage.
And down goes Shihu Papa. That's it. Really have to question the picks for Kongdu. Do you want to play EL Gaming's game? They made it to the World Finals off of this type of play, and you're going to try to challenge them? That's
bold.
Confident.
That is really, really bold. And
I think it's a bad idea.
Kongdu does not play like this. They're not known to play like this. They don't take the big fights like that. And especially when EL knew exactly where they were. The location was, they weren't sneaky enough. And like you said, this is EL's game. That's their formation.
Nice giving that big fist bump. Nice was the one who won them the game just by constantly positioning his turret so he wouldn't absorb, he wouldn't take damage. He absorbed 6 tanks worth of fire and took less than 200 damage.
That is pretty incredible.
And that means Elong's first burst of fire from all of their tanks hits critical targets and does serious damage because there is no heavy tank, there is no damage absorber in the composition of Kongdu. So things start to snowball, obviously, out of control.
All
I
right.
don't want to see that comp from Kongdu again. I don't. I just
I don't,
can't.
I don't think this map is very good for Kongdu at all. Yeah, they need to go with a composition that they're used to.
Oh, man, they're doing it though,
oh,
Susie.
Oh, gosh.
I think
is this
is a bad
what I
choice.
See?
I don't agree with this, but we'll have to see if they can make it work.
What's that last tank?
Probably an MT-25, but they could try to do a 12 ton.
Nope, it is the MT-25. They're going to go with the super lightweights one more time.
And EL is just going to counter this. They're just like, oh, okay. We've literally just beaten this before. We just crushed this. We can do this again.
You know, this reminds me of the Karen Tiger game yesterday where they lost with all those AMX, you know, the 1390s and the 5100s. Yet they went in the next game with it again.
Yeah.
And here's Kongdu doing exactly that. Maybe they have a different strategy planned using the same tanks.
Okay,
but
this is almost... Let me try to make an analogy for this. Imagine you're a track runner, you're a 100-meter sprinter, and you're up against a marathon runner, and you're saying, like, I want to run. It's like, well, do you want to race me in a sprint, or do you want to race me in a marathon? And he's like, yeah, I'll race you in the marathon. I'm like, but you're a sprinter. This is not what you're good at. You're playing against the person who's good at that style, and you're trying to mirror it when you could actually play a longer, more defensive, slower type game and actually do what you're good at, what you're best at.
So he like sprints like several times?
The analogy is backwards because in this case, Kongdu is being the sprinter and EL is the sprinter as well. And Kongdu is normally the marathon runner, but we're just going to see that 1390 12 ton counter pick again.
Yep, it looks like EL Gaming is also going to use the same lineup. We're going to have just.
Is Nice going to lock the T32 though?
Yes,
yes, he is.
He is the T32. So it's exactly the same lineup again. EL Gaming, they're like, you know, I think we could do it again. We could take this as long as they play it calm and collectively. Kongdu just needs to. If they're going to use this lineup, they need to be more aggressive.
Absolutely. They need to take an aggressive engagement with their first movement. Before they rotate, get an advantage before they rotate, or rotate faster so that EL doesn't have time to put Nice in the perfect spot and then just absorb all that damage from the high ground.
That was very, very well done by Nice, and EL Gaming really showing us that they are number one in Asia. They are a lot stronger than they were last year. And Kongdu, they're going to have to pull out something if they're going to, I mean, they might all even go to a 4-0.
My prediction, Susie, we're going to see a very similar game to the one we just watched.
All right, well, let's see how this works. We'll go straight into game number 4. All right, set number 4 has begun. EL Gaming versus Kongju. This is going to be the last game we see on this map. And EL up 3 games already, and they're on the defense. And like we've been saying, being on the defense is good. It's a benefit because you can wait for the time to run out.
Yeah. The Wolf saying, Wolf 2015, that time is your 8th tank. Like to put that way because it's just so true. You have an extra asset that your opponent just cannot utilize. They have to fight against it.
Right. This is very different from what I've seen Kongju do during their regular season. They usually don't take these blind shots. They don't want EL Gaming to know where they are, but they're doing it.
This time it makes sense. What they want to do here is confuse EL so they're not sure which point to defend, and then they're all going to collapse together, I think, and go together. But they need to do it soon.
Wow, that was very good positioning there by Reflection, trying to hide his 12-ton in that tiny little bush.
I mean, there's a very small chance that a stray shot actually hits him, so minimizing the surface area, very important. Okay, they're rushing to cap point 1 again. And I think that either they can pull a TCSG run style, 3 tanks in there, try to take a fight, or they can try to take a fight straight up and not try to cap, and then rotate afterwards. But if they're going to do the same thing, I feel like EL is just totally prepared for it. They literally have the best tanks to counter this, and they're in position.
All right, here we go. Kongju all running towards base capture number 1. And I don't know how Deong already took some damage, but he did.
I think it was just a blind shot from Elong that hit him. You know, just a stray round that they were firing out, just happened to connect.
All right, Kongju just going to try to use this high ground by the railroad tracks.
I like this, but
I really just want them to bring that fight. They need to be more aggressive.
If they could kill Reflection, if they could actually find out where he was with the MT-25, that could actually be a play that they could make. So Dudu is heading that way. If he finds Reflection and they can take him out here, that's a lot of lost damage for the next fight. So I think that if they could identify this, obviously we can see everything, so we know this. But if they could identify this, I think that would be the play. Oh no.
Dudu already taking some damage there. They know where he is.
Such a tiny tank.
Oh.
Alright, he's just gonna sack himself to try to get some information here.
There is such good accuracy on such, you know, this is, like you said, it's a tiny little tank, and yet they're able to hit him while he's on the move.
He doesn't find Reflection. He doesn't see him.
Oh, he didn't see him.
What he will see is every other tank and exactly where they are. So this could set them up for a good engagement, or they could focus down some of these T-54s. I don't know.
Oh, gosh.
He really wants to find Reflection. Reflection is not going to shoot him either.
No, he's not. He can't even move at this point. Be careful. You don't want him to see Reflection.
Just such a smart play by Elong. They've really thought of everything.
All right, Dudu is on his way back. They didn't find him. Goku Jungman also, he's up there as well.
He could take a blind shot into the bush. This is not like only EL Gaming does this, right? I mean, it's a common thing to do.
Okay, again,
so much time lost here.
I know.
So much time lost.
I was just going to say, it's 3 minutes and 45 seconds left now. Kongju really, as they attack, they need to go. They really need to be more aggressive.
We're getting to that time where, you know, they're not going to be able to rotate very easily. Reflection's still hidden. This is just one of those moments where, even as a spectator, if you're a Kongju fan, you're frustrated because you know that this is a losing battle they're trying to play right now.
Yep.
It's going to be a long, painful death if they don't form up and actually take an engage. Look at how split they are. They have good coverage on the map, but so what? Because EL Gaming is not going to move. They are not going to move. They are not going to the Venus Flytrap. There goes Dudu.
Dudu does go down now, and Kongju, 3 minutes left. They're down a tank.
Look at Gugu Jangman is trying to find a sixth sense. He's like, where is that 12-ton? But he's in the bush and he's not moving, so it's not going to go off.
All right,
Black Bear is getting really aggressive here.
They need to be. I mean, they're under 3 minutes now.
But he's going alone. I don't know if I like this. He's doing the same thing that Tutu just did. He just can't find reflection.
Nobody
he's
can
like,
find
where
reflection.
Is he? Where is he? If we can kill this guy, we can win
there.
The fight. But it's not going to happen. Oh, now it looks like he just wants to try to get some lucky shots.
All right, here we go.
And this is when reflection could actually fire on him.
Well, he is surrounded by Goku Jungman and Black Bear now. So I'm not sure if moving reflection would be the best idea. However, we can see here Nice and Fox and Black all ready for the cover fire.
2 minutes and 8 seconds left. This is just not good for Kongdu.
No.
They're not able
to
find any ground here.
This is definitely EL Gaming's map. This is definitely their game. And Kongdu, under 2 minutes with a composition like this, needed to have attacked sooner. All right, everyone needs to go in. This is the like the Hail Mary point now. They need to go ahead and try at least to take out members of EL Gaming. They can't capture. I mean, they still can, but I think that's a risky
reflection
play.
Reflection can hear all these tanks coming in. He sees the flicker on that sixth sense.
All right, and he'll let his team know everyone is coming.
Now, he can't visually see them, but he can guess how that they're all coming based on how this happened.
Wow,
now we
look
can just
at
turn
this.
On them. Look at the position here. You're not going to break this, never. They're going to rely on a miracle to win this.
Okay, here we go.
And Reflection turns
Reflection
around the second the battle starts.
Out, and now they are surrounded. This is the brawl that we're looking for. This is what Kongdu needed to have taken in the beginning of the game.
Boom, kills Red Bull instantly. And down goes Deung as well.
Yep.
Cal Thief in the middle of everything.
Shu Papa is taking a lot of damage as well. EL Gaming just so good at focus firing. There goes Cal Thief. And there's only two members left. This was so well done by EO Gaming.
Flawless victory. A 7-0 win for EO Gaming. Taking a 4-0 lead. Perfect plays. I have to say, Elong, in this moment, played perfectly, but really questionable tank picks from Kongdu. Perhaps they just knew that this was not going to be their map, and they were like, let's try this one more time. We're moving on to Himmelsdorf now, where we've got a better chance.
I don't know, man. I'm quite disappointed in Kongdu's play. This is not the Kongdu we saw yesterday, and I want them to be more confident in their own picks and what they're good at, not mimicking someone else,
yeah.
You know? All right,
if you're a marathon runner, you don't want to race the sprinter.
Something like that.
I mean, my analogy, I feel like...
I'm trying to get your analogy. It's okay.
Why would you... If you're a scientist, why would you challenge a mathematician at math if you could choose science over math? Like, if you could choose what competition you're going to compete in, why would you play against a person who's the best at what you're not the best at? You know, if you're not good at taking 7v7 tank battles, or if you're not as good as EL Gaming at 7v7 tank battles, why build a composition to try to beat them at that when they're on the defense so they have the defender's advantage?
Yeah.
It makes more sense if you're on the defender's side of things, but if you're on the attack, I'm like, this just probably isn't going to work, right? Especially after it failed so hard the first time they tried it. The second time it failed even worse. 7-0, no tanks destroyed.
All right, well, it is Himmelsdorf now. We are going into game number 5. And, I mean, remember, this is a best of 12. And so this next game, if EL Gaming wins it, it's still not over just yet. Kongdu can still come back.
Yeah.
But they are down 4 games already, Wolf.
Now, this should be a 3-map game. However, if EL wins 3 games in a row, we won't even see a 3rd map. Okay, we're probably going to see the standard 3 IS3, 250s, 250-100s. T32, K is coming
in. Oh, yeah. T32, please, Kongdu, just go something standard, something you're good at.
Okay. Don't know who's going to attack first. We'll find out once you get in the game. But,
so far, it looks like...
We might be able to figure it out.
Okay, here we go. The 3 IS3s. AMX 5100s, this is very standard. I'm a little bit happier with Kongdu's pick here.
Yeah, me too. I think EL might tech in a 1390 if they're on the attack. Mm. Let's see though, because we don't know yet. A T37 for Kongdu.
Yes, this is very, very common. This is a very standard pick for Himmelsdorf. I'm glad Kongdu's doing it. Hopefully they're good at it.
The T37 is great for the corner cap, so it starts to look like Kongdu is on the attack with the T32 in the mix as well. A fourth IS-3 wouldn't hurt here for EL. They could bring a 1390. They could also do the new LTTB meta. You know, you bring the two LTTB tanks in.
That's true. Yeah, yeah. We saw that being very successful yesterday. No, but we have a fourth IS-3.
Fourth IS-3.
This is definitely a defensive comp.
Absolutely. So the last one could be a 12-ton. There it is.
Yep.
So extra damage. So we can just tell by these tanks alone that Kongdu is going to be on the attack. But that, you know what, a 12-ton can also be in the capture point, but more than likely it's going to be Kongdu on the attack. We'll find out for sure once we get in the game.
Soon we will be in the game, and we're going to take a look at Himmelsdorf. I apparently butcher the way you say this.
That's all right.
My German pronunciation is no good.
It's hard to say it with a German pronunciation. I studied German for several years, but still can't do it. So I won't blame you for that one, Susie.
All right. Well, thank you very much. I'm glad you're not blaming me for butchering the word. But all right, guys, here we go. Game number 5 will unfold very shortly. All right, set number 5. First game on Himmelsdorf, and this is very different from Steps. A lot more buildings, all these little alleyways, and, you know, obviously heavier tanks, and so we're going to have to see how this is going to pan out. This might be actually better for Kongdu. Kongdu is known for their play on the city maps, more so than the big open ones, so we'll see if they can, you know, pull out a win here.
So it's going to be EL on the attack, so I was wrong. The 12-ton is also good for putting in the corner. But, you know, it's got less hit points, slightly less armor. If it gets hit, it's going to die, right?
Mm-hmm. Well,
but
yeah,
it is smaller, so it can't be hit unless someone exposes themselves. So we are going to see EL push down the center. They've got 5100s covering the railroad tracks. Again, this is very standard. We've seen them do this almost every game they play. I'd say about 1 out of 4 games EL's on the attack, they go for the depot push, but they're not going to start that way in this first attack game.
Oh, wow. We got the 4 IS-3s just... They're just marching down this road. Cow Thief, however, is getting ready for them. See if he can catch... Oh, they saw. Yeah, okay. Black Bear was able to see this push, this incredible IS-3 push.
Okay, they're going to split black in the middle. Guanren's probably going to go left here. Okay, actually, he's going to push down. It's looks like Adam is going in the middle. And then they're going to put the 12-ton in the corner cap. So they're going to have all this coverage on Reflection, of course, is on the 12-ton. Full coverage there. Fox on the 5100 for extra damage. And now he's in the corner.
Yes, and now he's going to start that base capture. This is a very standard play by EL, and this makes Kongdu have to come out and do something about it. Oh, they stuck another tank and their timer is down. Ooh, is that 3 tanks?
Yep, 3 tanks, and they're actually being a bit more aggressive than I expected.
Nice.
That starts to speak volumes to the IS-3, the 4 IS-3 pick, because this is easier to do with this.
Okay, and Kongdu has to do something about it. They know where it is. Theong is going to take some damage for peeking out his face a little too far.
This is a great strat for game one. This is an awesome thing to do when you get into your opponent's heads. Look at that. Poking out and taking a shot on Diem while you're capping. Accuracy. EL, one of the best in the world at this.
Yes, absolutely. We've been seeing this all summer long. This is amazing to see here on an international stage for playing against Korea, the best Korean team as there is. They're going to all pull out. They have 14 seconds left. They're just going to stay in this base.
I can't even believe this. They're actually just going to push their way through. Like, yeah, we will kill you,
Red
actually.
Red Bull does go down. There is 7 seconds left. Everyone is in this base capture right now. They're just going to defend it with their lives.
Dudu coming from behind might be able to hit some shots here, but it's not going to matter. They do take out Black.
All right, they do, and they're starting to hit different members and restart the base timers, but...
This is a tough engagement for Kongdu to take, but I feel like EL might have gotten a bit ahead of themselves here. This is still winnable for Kongdu, absolutely. Adam's so low right now, and Reflection
he
trying
really
to get some good
is.
Shots.
One of these tanks are going to have to go hide once more, and I think that's going to be Fox. He's going to go and...
Oh, that was a great shot!
Wow.
Great shot on Reflection. You know, you notice that Adam is blocking from it. It's totally worth it for Adam to die instead of the 12-ton, because Adam is never going to do the same amount of damage that the 12-ton can. Okay.
All right. So, yeah, they're just going to keep Reflection in the back now. He's the one
but
that's
Fox,
safe.
Fox is almost reloaded, and he's coming around the corner. That's what Shio Papa is looking for.
Oh, no. Shio Papa.
But Shio Papa is reloading for a while. All he can do is spot for this. Already, Fox starting to put the damage down. And Shio Papa is basically doomed. He's actually going to ignore him. He knows he's out of rounds. And a great rotation here by Fox from the behind.
Cal Thief does go. Yep. He's going to burn to death.
That looks like it. Does burn down, and this is looking like the beginning of the end here in Game 5, as they're no longer able to deny this. 250-100s versus a tanky cop. Fox burns down.
Shio Papa does take out Fox, but doesn't matter. They get the capture, and they win.
EL looking flawless, untouchable in this series. And this is not what I expected. Now, my theory, I can never be 100% sure about this. You know, we might have to talk to Kongdu about this probably in a few days, not today. But I feel like there's some disagreements with some of the calls because they're moving not together. They're getting caught off guard by this. They got into such a bad position that EL was able to just put like six tanks in the capture. And instead of hiding back there, they just went out to meet Kongdu. And Kongdu was so flustered by this, they lost so many hit points, they lost so many members early on.
That's exactly what I expected from
then,
EL.
Then they actually overextended, but Fox was the hero. He came from behind with all that AMX 5100 damage, and that was all they needed.
You know, I expect games like this during our Asian season. I know EL has been absolutely amazing on Himmelsdorf then too, but to bring it here versus Kongju, the number one Korean team, the number one team that won every single one of these seasons. What can Kongju do at this point? EL is looking so strong.
I don't know, Susie. I don't have an answer this time.
Is that your answer? Is that the official answer? The Wolf answer?
That's the Wolf answer, but they're going to show us in this tank picks at least what they've got planned.
I can't believe this. You know,
composition problems were not a thing. I mean, it was not a composition problem here.
No,
it was
they were outplayed.
Yeah.
They were absolutely outplayed. That was a strategical thing. And now here we go. I can't believe EL is up 5-0 now. And it's
two wins
first,
to go.
Yeah, first to seven, man.
Three ISBs in the T32. 5100s.
Again, it's not the composition. This is a very standard composition. Like we said, T37, the T32s, heavier tanks. They've got the damage. They've got the scout. I mean, what can they do now? Yeah, Reflection.
Oh, China, baby. Oh!
That is badass.
An EL gaming tattoo.
I hope he never gets traded to another team.
Well, let's talk about loyalty for a second.
Wow.
Hardcore. Now, let's talk about what EL Gaming could change. They could bring 250-100s instead of a 4th IS3. As I'm saying it, that's what they're going to do. I suppose they could still technically go 4 IS3s with this, but they would lose a T32 for it. I think that's what they're going to do.
Wow.
I think we're going to see 4 IS3s again.
I've got new respect for Reflection, man.
That was pretty rad. I'm not going to lie. It was so funny if then he like picked a Chinese like autoloader. I'm like, whoa. I'm like, that's not very good though.
Well, I mean, the 5916s aren't that bad.
Yeah.
That can totally be a viable pick here. Another IS3. They're definitely going heavy here.
I think just one more IS3.
Yeah, Cow Thief is like, what do we do? What do we do? Yep, there's the 4 IS3s now.
And of course, with that, it already means we're going to see a 12-ton. So, they're going to go for that corner cap again. Kongdu needs to respond faster. And they need to have that one IS3 that's always there to block. They had nothing. There was nobody there. Might have been a comms issue. I really don't know. I can't tell you guys. But something is not right. And Cal Thief looked insanely nervous in the interview. Looking nervous now. And he's the man who holds everything together.
I know. He is their shot caller. So, all right, guys, here we go. We're going into the next game. Is this going to be a shutout? We're going to have to wait and see. Here we go, set number 6. And EL Gaming versus Kongdu. EL is up 5 games. Kongdu, however, are now on the defense. So they could use this clock to their advantage if they don't get eliminated by EL from the beginning.
All right, let's see how they go.
All right, we've got the crowd cheering for the Korea team.
Hashtag EL Gaming. They're going for the push to the first capture point, it looks like. We saw them do this every now and then in the round robin stage of this tournament before playoffs. They could also again rotate through the right side of the courtyard and go to that corner capture point, but I would love to see them go for the depot cap, the
All
capture
right.
point for one.
Dudu going right to the middle of the courtyard. This is what we usually see. Oh no, he's actually going through, and he wants to see what they're up to. This is a...
It's a scout move. Are they coming this way or not? Or are they all going up the castle? That's basically what you can gain. You can gain that knowledge. You can't see how many tanks are here, because your sixth sense isn't going to tell you that. But you can see that tanks are there, and so therefore they're not all pushing rapidly like they did last game.
Yeah.
So it's a bit of a different style here.
Dudu can definitely hide in that little spot. He's a tiny little tank.
Reflection shot here.
Reflection does feel him, though, feeling each other out.
Yeah.
Would you say Dudu is a reflection of him?
No, I wouldn't. I think Dudu and Reflection are totally different personalities, especially based on what we see on camera. Of course, I'm just making fun of you for making that pun. I was the pun guy yesterday. It could be you today, Susan.
Okay. I had to get one in there. All right. Wow.
Dudu could get taken up by Black if he connects. Oh, he misses.
Oh, he was so close. But they see him. They know he's there. And, okay.
Reflection actually using some autoloader shots for this, but if he gets the kill, it's worth it. If he doesn't, he might even want to just blow those so he can start his reload so he has full damage for later, to be totally honest.
I think
that's exactly what he's doing.
Dudu does go down. Spring is able to finish that job. Kongju already down one tank. I just feel like Kongju are getting outplayed by every corner, you know?
It seems like the variety of plays from PL is real, too. I mean, on the attack, they're taking different approaches to both maps, whereas Kongju seems to be kind of pigeonholing themselves into one sort of strategy.
Oh, Kalthi taking some damage there.
But so does Black.
Yes, but he's now surrounded. I mean, what can Kalthi do? He's going to be shot from the back. Yep, there you go.
He gets Black, so that's okay, but now they've lost their T32.
Yes.
And they've lost their shot caller. He's going to have to rely on other people telling him information and then feeding information to them. Oh, man, Black Bear's going to go down
Bear
as well.
Black Bear goes down. Just these surrounds, man. EL really finding exactly where to be. Their positioning is so good in this game.
Susie, are you familiar with the Korean game Go, where you like surround with circles and squares?
Yeah.
This is why I feel like I'm watching a game of Go with World of Tanks right now. Getting surrounded, getting outplayed at every turn. Now, Kongju does have the hit point lead, but they're not in a good position tank-wise, the tanks they've got left.
No, they are not.
If Gugu Jungman goes down here, they're going to lose their damage.
Red Bull is trying to come around and see if he can help him out, but I don't think there's only three tanks left. Deong, Gugu Jungman.
Okay, here we go. Spring going to go for the kill on Red Bull here. This is a questionable choice. It's risky, because Red Bull's in a nice spot over here. He's got pretty good coverage, but...
Yeah, but there's three tanks on him. Might as well. If they can kill one, then might as well go for it. Adam is going to come out. Finish this off, one more shot, there you go.
Spring's on reload for a while, but so is Gugu Jungman. As this is looking like a win here in game six, no doubt about it. Because with a 5100 and IS-3, it's not like you're going to be able to escape for 3 minutes. That's not happening. They're going to hunt them down and kill them.
All right, he is now reloaded. Gugu Jungman has all his shells now.
A lot of tanks are low.
Oh.
Oh, man, the miss. A lot of tanks are low, so it is possible that if he hits every shot, he could win, but he's already missed one.
Okay.
Nice goes down.
All right, Deong does take out one.
Oh, and another ricochet here. But Reflection gets the kill with the second round. And now all they have to do is kill that awesome Oinker, man.
The Oinker, Mr. Piggy, awesome Piggy man.
Well, oink, oink, here we come. Now singing the capture point. Five rounds left. There are four tanks left, but only Reflection will die to one shot. Fox with a critical would die. And then after that, he's just going to be overwhelmed.
There's three autoloaders that are full. I really don't think Gugu Jungman has a chance
He can kill Reflection with one shot.
All right, that's one.
That's step one. Step two is to kill Fox. If he can get a critical on Fox, maybe he could turn this around. Oh, he's looking the wrong way, though. And Spring finds him, and there he goes.
Fox gets him. EL Gaming taking game number six.
6-0. Would never have expected this going into the finals.
I can't believe this. This is not what I expected at all.
I was favoring Kongju slightly.
Me too.
nerves
too.
Or something, or EL is prepared insanely well.
I am at a loss of words right now. I mean, I know EL has been great. Like I said, we've watched them all season. They've been dominating the Asia scene. But coming into this game, I thought it was going to be closer. Especially how Kongdu beat Karen Tigers yesterday.
Yeah. Wow.
I have nothing else to say, man.
Reflection is playing out of his mind. He's making good calls. He's sending his team the right directions. And, you know, I always have, like, the shot caller is usually the guy I give the most credit to. If I have to give it to someone else, I would give it to Fox. Fox is on point with his AMXs today. Also, you know, just coming from behind, his rotations, I'm guarantee you Reflection is telling him, all right, come in right now. Then he comes in, and he just doesn't miss. He just doesn't miss.
All right, we're going to take a short break. We'll be right back with possibly the last game.
Slowpokes, Sector B6, C7 and D8. Hughes will be there in 30 seconds. Prepare, those born to fly can't tank. Affirmative. Guys, I'm holding the flag, but it's getting hot here. Hang in there, we'll back you up soon. Go easy. I'll try, but there'll be a lot of scrap metal. The 7th enemy vehicle destroyed. I'm running out of ammo. At least don't run out of extra combat rations.
Like the pros with the exclusive AMX 1357 eSports tank. Hit the battlefield in style with a unique Wargaming Tech lead paint job. Fight your enemies' weak sides and rear with this rapid French premium tank. Destroy targets in one clip with the 57mm auto-loading gun. Don't miss your chance to snag it. Learn more about the exclusive eSports tank at AMX1357.com. Watch the elite compete for the right to be crowned.
Okay, guys, here are the highlights that we just saw in the last few games. And unfortunately, I'm going to say it's probably mostly Heal Gaming highlights.
Well, I mean, let's kind of watch these highlights and talk about some of the things that went wrong with Kong here. So, on the steps map, they were picking the tanks to directly combat EL Gaming directly in their style, in the straight-up fights. And unfortunately, it turns out EL Gaming is the best team in the world at this. They changed the meta off the back of this style.
No, really?
And so, you know, I feel like Kongdu comes to this maybe with the confidence that actually they're the best. But what we learned today is that's not true. And they tried it several times, and EL was able to eliminate them four maps in a row.
This he's like the Dark Templar of this game, you know? Like, he just sat there completely, like, invisible to everyone.
And then in the end, he carries. He's the Dark Templar, he's the AD carry, you know, whatever other esports games you could bring into this, that's reflection in this moment.
Wow. Yeah, like we said, I mean, most of these highlights, it is EL Gaming just dominating every single map, every single game. It doesn't even matter about the picks. They're just out-rotating, they're out-strategizing, is that a word?
Yes.
Like, they're just playing absolutely incredible, and this could be it. This could be the last game of the evening.
It absolutely could. We've got two games left on this map. So, let's see if they can actually grab the wins to survive into the third map. Because if they can't do that, then
we don't even get to see what the third map is.
We don't even know what it is.
Oh,
probably,
my gosh.
It's probably Lakeville, I would guess. But we might not get there.
Yeah, but you know what? We've seen EL on Lakeville. That's a really good map for them, too.
Yeah.
So I'm not sure. Yeah, one more game, and that could be it. That could be the entire finals.
So we're going to be, like, switching sides now. So EL, insanely good attack strategies, patient play.
There's
WarGaming.net. Got some support from the brass up at the top.
He is
coming down to watch these Asian teams play excellent World of Tanks. Very honored that he's here.
He's probably sitting here going, what is going on?
Someone's got to get him a radio headset so he can listen to our commentary.
Do we really want that, though?
Yeah, I want him. I want to say hi to him. I want him to hear me.
I just want to go back to EL Gaming. This is going to be history in the making. If they win this,
it'll be their first title.
Yes, it's their first title.
First major title.
Plus beating their rival, if you will.
Yeah.
You know?
They've lost to Kongdu in the past, in the most recent season as well. Kongdu has dominated. And this will be the first time they beat the rivals and the first time to take a title, and they'll take a Korean title against the defending champions, against the home team here in Korea, and they're up 6-0. Let's see these picks now that sides have switched. You know, the four IS-3s for EL, a little bit less appealing on the defense, but still viable.
Still viable, man. And EL Gaming, I almost want to say they could even troll pick at this point and it wouldn't affect them too much.
Yeah, I don't think they will, though. I think they want the 7-0 more than anything else now. Like, what they wanted was a title, and now they want the 7-0, so they can rub it in their faces even more. Especially with all the smack talk we saw from Kongdu and Kalthi
earlier.
That
is true. They're like, oh, I'm so sorry you came all the way here for second place.
He's even talking trash in Chinese. I'm like, whoa.
EL Gaming didn't understand any of it except for that one word. It was like, we gotta win the 7-0.
Exactly.
All right, we've got IS-3s on both sides, score on the board now.
Ooh, 350s, 5100s, and a 12-ton. So there's a lot of damage on this, but it makes me wonder if they're going to actually go for the corner cap.
Yes, and again, they need to be aggressive. With, God, there's so many tanks that do damage. If they're just going to hold back and wait around and be indecisive, once they're out, they're out. They're going to die.
Yeah. Okay, let's see how many IS-3s in total.
There's a lot of IS-3s. That's a lot of 5100s as well.
Another option is to roll the 1390.
Yeah.
T32, something Kalthi. That EL is not favoring here.
Oh man, Kalthi looks pretty stressed out. Unless he's already given up at this point.
I don't think he has. Uh-oh, are we going to see the tattoo again? He like shows a tattoo and picks an SPG. I'm like, whoa. So,
right,
25100s,
yeah.
Which means probably a fourth IS-3.
Yeah.
And then go T37 here. They could 12-ton it, but don't think so.
Mm.
They also 59-16.
I think the T37 is a safer bet here.
Yeah.
They know how it moves on this map. They know all the crevices, the garage picks that they can just kind of, you know, fit into. They know how this tank works. Tried and true. I think we go with that.
Well, all picks are made. The four IS-3s have been working well for EL, of course, now switching sides. Let's see if Kongdu can get in that corner cap point and use their 5100s to output that damage, because they sacrifice safety for damage here with this pick. It's a bold choice. We'll see if they can actually make this work. I am nervous.
I am very nervous for Kongdu.
But this is one of the bold choices that Kongdu has made that I can really agree with. I can say, you know what? I do like this.
All right. Well, this is their last chance to prove themselves. Here we go into the next game. Set number 7. Here we are. EL Gaming versus Kongdu. This could be it, guys. EL Gaming, one more game, and they win it. They are the champions of the WGL APAC Asia Season 1 Finals. And like you said, here's Kongdu with their super, super strong lineup.
It's auto-loaded damage.
So much damage. Tons of damage, one might say.
Terrible, terrible damage. I've heard that before somewhere. Now, let's see if they can make this work. The pushes we're seeing so far, actually, they're going to go for the AMX 5100 to the north. They bring one to the south with the 12 tons. We usually have those AMXs to the south to make sure there's no sort of big backwards rotation, because that happens every now and then, like one out of 100 games, but you do have to check for it.
Okay, I like EL Gaming's. They're going with a very standard defensive position, especially around base capture number two. I like the fact that Reflection has come out to the railroad side, because more and more teams have been contesting this area.
Reflection is challenging Dudu here,
yeah.
And he's trying to see if he can get some straight shots. Also, if Dudu fires, then he's losing some of his rounds. So it's a win-win situation for the T37 at that range. Now we do see Black Bear up here trying to get some information as well as perhaps a shot or two of damage.
Build.
Exactly.
Bube, that's his name.
Now, they're backing off. And they're going to rotate around, it looks like, to the south, leaving the 5100s on the high ground at the castle, but backing off, slowly moving around to the bottom left.
I think they're going to go for base capture number one.
Reflection is just firing off blind shots here. He knows that there's a chance of this happening. He's looking for Dudu, but it's actually way off. He doesn't have a visual on him.
Right, but what a great position for Reflection right here. The T-37 fits perfectly inside this old train station.
Yeah. Guan Ren's position is excellent as well. He's going to see tanks coming. He's going to know they're coming. But again, EL having a very good defensive position in the north. But if this push comes, there's a good opportunity for Kongdu. Really good opportunity.
Yes, we've actually seen this flipped. EL Gaming has done this over the summer. And EL Gaming, yeah, like you said, they're all the way up north. They're
nobody
back,
except Reflection.
Yep, and the backup's going to be too late. Remember, these are all heavy tanks. They're not as fast as the ones that we've seen before.
And they're moving through Himmelsdorf, so it's not like they can go as the crow flies. They have to move around all these buildings.
Ooh, Guan Ren taking some shots.
See,
from
this is
Black
smart.
Bear.
Black Bear on the hill there, doing so much, and another shot as well. If Guan Ren goes down, this is a great opportunity for Kongdu. Also, the base capture is going to start in just a moment.
Oh, that ricochet, though, on top. Oh.
Guan Ren cannot challenge Black Bear, but Black Bear only has one round left.
All right. And one more from Black Bear, and he's on a reload. There we go. 43 seconds till he can shoot again.
There's still a lot of time on the clock, and Kongdu is not rushing the cap.
Shoot, Papa's up there too. He's like, I want to get in on this fun.
Let's take turns. While you're reloading, I'll fire. I mean, it's a smart choice, but nothing's able to connect. Bonner just continue to buy time here.
While they're doing this, I feel like Kongdu should be capping base capture number one, because while this fire is going on, look at this. EL Gaming already realizing that everyone's down south. They're making their way down there, and Kongdu's not going to have enough time to make a move.
The scary thing, though, is Fox is nearby now. Fox is nearby. And it looks like Adam has joined them. So they do have coverage of that base. Guan Ren goes down,
okay, finally, but I don't know, man. They're gonna try to capture this. Oh, Diong is taking some damage though.
Yeah, but it's gonna absorb a lot of the Spring's rounds here, so it does give them some opportunities, especially if he escapes. And he will escape, it looks like, initially. Now he wants Kaldheep's back off, but Kaldheep is far away.
He is too far away. It is a 3v1 in this situation. Wow, he misses. Diong is still alive.
Two rounds left for Spring, and there he goes. Diong is down. Spring's got one round left. He needs to make it count.
Fox goes down as well off camera here. And now the whole fight is down at the south side of this map.
All right, Dudu kills Reflection. Reflection is down. Shio Papa coming around the back here. They're going to catch Black.
He's going to be able to get Black.
Oh, the first shot misses Black. If he can kill Red Bull, then escape. That would be so sick. Can he do it? Oh, he's alive for now.
So low. 48 HP.
And now he goes down.
Zero.
Kongdu with a massive lead in this game. But 2:30 left on the clock. Nice versus Kaldheep. Ending up being a crazy little engagement over there. Spring's still reloading.
All right, Red Bull does go down at him, but then they trade it. Kaldheep takes down Nice. It is a 2v5.
An excellent position for Kongdu, the best position they've had in this entire series. Now Kaldheep will go down. Looks like Spring's gonna have to use a round to do it. It's unfortunate, but it had to be done. About 125 seconds left on the clock.
Kongdu knows if they let EL Gaming win this, the series is over.
Only autoloaders remain for Kongdu. So every round counts.
Right.
But they've got so many of them.
Yeah, Dudu and Black Bear and Gurgur, they're all full right now.
This is a great move. Try to use Adam to, or Spring to bait so Adam can do damage. It's not going to matter though. It looks like Adam's going to fall.
Yes,
Dudu escapes. And now this looks like a win here for Kongdu, their first win.
Wow, they did it.
They do take it. The crowd goes wild. And we are here in Korea. This Korean team takes its first win.
Oh, you can see the relief on their faces. Look at this. There's Kalki.
Very, very, very well played.
Wow. Is this comeback?
It could be. Going against what they've been doing, what the norm is on this map, bring three AMX 5100s to the table. It was something that's rare. We usually don't see this. Kongdu, some of the picks they had today didn't make a lot of sense to me. I was worried about it. This is a pick I think some people would be worried about. I wasn't, because I knew they've got all this auto-loader damage. They picked off early on an IS-3, and then they always kind of took turns who was firing, so it was never a moment where, we're on reload, what are we gonna do?
I was a little bit worried because it took them a while to really get there, right? But I like the fact that the rest of EO was up north. Kongdu had a great opportunity to start the fights in position down south part of the map, and I think that really worked to their advantage.
We didn't see it on camera. It was also a big blunder for Reflection to get taken out as early as he did as well, because with his auto-loader damage, they could have actually contested it, you know? They could have actually made this a closer game. Didn't happen that way, though.
Right, we get to see... Kongdu gets to see another map.
They live to see another map if they survive the last map, the last game on Himmelsdorf, I should say.
So yeah, this is the last time we're going to be on Himmelsdorf, guys. And again, Kongdu, I mean, that must have given them a surge of confidence.
Fast locks here, I think they're doing the same thing. Look at that.
Ooh, that's a lot of damage.
How does EL counter this? Because they've dealt with this once already before. You know what? One way to deal with this is to take in 1390s, because they are autoloaders that are faster. Another thing they could do is run five IS-3s, not even kidding, and run only one 5100. A little bit more tankiness, a lot more longevity, harder for Kongdu to actually get the kills that they need.
I don't know though, that's a lot of damage coming out of those 5100s. Three of them, in fact.
They could also, another response would be, for EL to also run three 5100s.
That's what I was thinking.
I think they might bring a 1390 into the picture. I would really like to see that.
You want me to go in there and let them know? I could be the coach?
Two 5100s.
Okay.
LTTBs also wouldn't be too bad here either.
Hmm. I think I would rather see two LTTBs than one T37. I think they would do a little bit more in distracting Kongdu.
Yeah, they'll lose some tankiness with that though. Let's see what they choose.
Yeah, Reflection's also thinking about it too.
Yeah. I want to see 1390.
Another IS-3.
Could just be four IS-3s again. They might just be saying, you know what, let's just stick with the same and play a little bit differently. Let's react a little bit faster.
That could be it too.
They can't use the same strat twice and get away with it.
Oh, we've seen that though.
What I'm trying to say is that's the mindset he might have here. Okay, four IS-3s.
Four IS-3s and then
T-37, no doubt.
T-37, yeah. Okay. So same lineup. They're just going to hopefully play it differently and then win this. That's probably their game plan right now.
All right, Susie. Still match point here for EL Gaming.
Kongdu has a very large mountain to climb if they're going to come back from this.
And they've already shown this strategy once. This is going to now be the second time they're rolling with this.
Okay, guys.
I'm actually feeling pretty tense. I'm pretty nervous.
This is crazy. This could be it, guys. Set number 8. Like we said, this could be game point again. This is EL Gaming up 6 games. Kongdu does take 1, and they are on the attack.
Okay, let's see how Kongdu is going to approach this. Because if they do the same sort of approach, it doesn't mean it's not going to work. But I feel like EL's response will be a lot more crisp. It'll be a lot faster. I don't know. What do you think? I feel like I would like it if Kongdu does the same thing. Like, exactly the same thing.
But yeah, wouldn't EL Gaming be expecting that?
I think it's still their best shot. It's the strongest they've looked in this series. And honestly, Black Bear was doing great with the 5100s.
Okay.
All right, Reflection actually gets a shot off on Dudu. That's what he wasn't able to accomplish last game.
That was very, very well done. EL Gaming this time not going all the way up to base capture number two. They're going to go straight into the courtyard. There's a ton of IS-3s here, and I think they want to bring the fight. This is what they're good at. If they get the pounce on them first, I think they'll be able to take the fight.
This is actually very tense, because Yale is so aggressively right now. They're actually blocking all points. They're actually just boxing Kongdu in. This is their response here. Now, this doesn't necessarily mean that Kongdu's composition is no longer viable. They just have to transition, and they are going to do just that. They're all going to send all their tanks up to the high ground, up where the castle is. I think this is the perfect way to respond to how EL is starting things off, how they formed up. And now what EL is going to have to do is realize this and then go and block that corner cap. And because Dudu is so low, this is very scary. You know, it's harder to actually get that corner cap.
All right, so there they go, up to the castle. I mean, but EL can just block them off on both sides, really.
They have to respond, though. They have to rotate.
I really like
Kongdu's position. I like how they're responding
a lot. I really like EL's position here. They're all gathering forward. They know that there's going to be a big fight going on. They do not want to be spread out on this map. They want to be there to be able to give that cover fire when they need it.
They need to, though, kind of go up around the side and stop the tanks from rotating around, you know, the top right of the castle. If they get a good position on that lane that goes straight to the capture point, they can kind of charge through. There is a 5100 there, though, ready to spot. Like you said, it's Fox.
Do you think that they're going to, that EL is actually going to go up that castle and see if they can meet them up there?
I don't think they're going to go up there, but what they're going to do is form their IS-3s right at the bottom. You see what they're doing here?
Oh, yeah.
So if you come down, you're dead. So don't you dare come down. And also, if they stop and there's no sixth sense, they can surprise Kongdu when they come around the corner.
They absolutely can.
And that's what they're going to do. They're going to wait.
Oh my gosh.
This could be a disaster, but if Kongdu targets properly, if they react properly, they could win this fight. Here we go. Already a really good fight here for EL.
Wow, and we can see Dion took a lot of damage here. Everyone's getting chipped off a bit.
And Fox!
We have Fox with the cover fire from behind.
Always what Fox is best at, that support. Black Bear so low now, and he's one of their main damage dealers.
Wow.
Okay, Cal Thief and Shio Papa, though, were able to sneak around the right side.
Kongdu definitely had an advantage there, but they were not able to connect anything. And Cal Thief is going to try to come around, but
no. Spring on point.
Wow.
Goodbye, Cal Thief. Might be the last time we see you in this tournament. And now he's going to have to rely on his teammates. He can give them advice, but he can't actually do anything.
Oh, no. Shio Papa is going to be the next one. He's going to die before he can even get his rounds off.
Oh man, Kongdu is being dominated right now. Look at this. Black Bear is trying to do some risky shots here. It's all he can hope for.
But Black Bear, the moment he shows his face, you know he's going to be the prime target. They want to get rid of him. Kuku Jungman trying to do his best, but he now only has one shot.
Reflection coming
left
to kill Black Bear from behind. See you later. And now Kuku Jungman solo. Shio Papa's down. Dudu is down. This is going
to
be it.
This is going to be it.
And EL is going to take it, possibly with a flawless seven-tank finish. Down goes Dion, and Red Bull's the last man standing. And Spring is nearly reloaded. It's going to be a 7-0 finish. EL Gaming are your champions.
Wow. Wolf, this was an amazing last game. EL Gaming, again, like you said, perfect game. All their tanks left alive, and they just beat Kongdu at their own strategy.
Oh, man. A really good last attempt there by Kongdu. I liked what they were doing, but they didn't know the IS-3s were in waiting. And even though they should have been able to take a fight, you get flustered, you're not aiming properly, because you're hitting IS-3s, you know, they're armored, there's a lot of ricochet.
Yep.
And that gave the rest of the tanks time to get into position. Fox, the support fire.
That was brilliantly done. EL Gaming just so smart. Their strategies were on point, and their accuracy was on point. Today was just a perfect day. All the stars and moons have aligned for EL Gaming today.
This is EL's very first premier tournament win. Their very first one. And they win on foreign soil here in Korea, defeating their rivals, defeating Kongdu with a 7-1 score, with a 7-0 in the final game. Two perfect games, two games where they lose no tanks.
I can't even believe it. Wow. That's it. I'm done talking now. This game was just left me speechless.
Well, we'll see Kongdu again next season. They played some great games. I'm looking forward to seeing if they can make it to the World Finals as well.
All right, we've got EL Gaming coming across.
Raising that Chinese flag.
Raising that Chinese flag. They're going to go and shake the hands of the guys in Chengdu. Very good sportsmanship there.
You know.
Oh, look at that hug.
No doubt Reflection and Kaltheep actually probably practice together every now and then. You know, there's not too much latency between the servers. And these guys are rivals. Finally, amongst all the trash talking, Kaltheep is defeated.